Welcome to your yoga practice today. Today it's all about celebration, so we're going to be doing a lot of invigorating vinyasas and transitions and really getting warm, which sounds like fun. But we're also going to then dial it back, do some deep stretching, and then kind of release into those relaxation postures. So it should be a fun balance. Let's start in a nice easy pose, gently rocking from side to side. Pull the flesh away from the sits bones and pull the low belly in. Draw it in and allow the backs of the hands to relax on the knees. Gently close your eyes and take a nice deep inhale in through the nose. Exhale out through the mouth. Completely emptying the lungs and pulling the belly in. Let's do that one more time. Inhale. Exhale. And now gently close the mouth and begin with the nasal breathing, inhaling in through the nose and exhaling out through the nose. With each breath growing taller through the spine, reaching the crown of the head toward the sky, pulling the torso in. Feel the open palms kind of pull some energy in from the sky. On your next inhale, reach the arms up, shift the gaze up toward the sky, open up the heart. And exhale, forward fold, relaxing over the hips, reach the forehead toward the earth. Inhale. Exhale, roll up through the spine. Shoulders up and back. Inhale, bring the hands up. And exhale, lower the palms down, bringing them behind you one at a time. Just kind of walking those arms back. You can shift the fingertips so they're pointing toward the hips. Reclining back, soften the elbows, stretch through the front of the shoulder, shift the gaze up. You can even kind of shrug, relaxing those shoulders into the skull. Lift up the chest on the next inhale and fold over, reach out and round. Roll up through the spine. Tall, tall, tall inhale. And as you exhale, gently twist, bring the palm across the thigh. Inhale back to center. Exhale, twist it to the left. Bring it back to center. And we're going to cross the ankles and rotate into a table, bringing the knees under the hips. Pull the belly in, nice long spine. Inhale, gaze forward, lower the belly down. Exhale, round the back, spread the shoulder blades apart, come into a nice deep cat stretch. Inhale up, exhale down. Inhale up, exhale down. Inhale up, exhale down, inhale up, and bring it back to neutral. Step both feet back into a high plank, pull the belly in, contract the chest, open up the upper back, holding that high plank, pull the muscles kind of up away from the kneecaps, pull those quads up high, inhale, exhale, lower the knees down and flatten out the feet. Bring the elbows in and lift up, just coming halfway up, and then lift back to the knees and come back into a high plank. We're gonna do 5 rounds of that. Knees come down, lower down, just halfway up. Lift the knees back up, curl the toes under into a plank. Inhale, exhale, knees down, nice, small movement, knees up, back into a plank. Inhale. Exhale, lower the knees down, elbows in. Nice, tight movement through the triceps. One more, down. And into that high plank, go ahead and lower the knees down. Press the hips back, coming into a child's pose, relax the forehead on the mat. Lengthen through those lats. On the next inhale, shift the gaze forward, curl the toes under, lift the hips up, high plank. Inhale. into a chair series. You're gonna bring the palms together, sit back onto the heels, gently tuck the tailbone under, kind of stack the ribs with the spine, hold the chair, inhale, exhale. Now since this is a celebration, let's inhale and open the chest up toward the sky, shift the arms, the gaze up, the arms are open, pulling all that joy into the heart, inhale, exhale, pull the hands in, sink a little bit lower into the chair. Inhale, open up the heart again. And exhale, forward fold. Now I'm going to face the side. You can stay facing the same direction. You're going to inhale up. And exhale, hands to heart. We're going to do that again. Inhale, reach the arms up, sink the hips back. Chair pose, gently tuck the tailbone under. Line the back of the ribs with the spine. Inhale. Exhale, keep that gaze slightly lifted. Open up the palms, kind of stretching the fingertips as wide as you can. Inhale. Exhale, pull the hands into the heart. Inhale, lift up through the spine and gently rotate, bringing the left elbow across the right thigh. Gentle twist. Inhale. Exhale, release it back to the center. Nice and low through the chair. Toes and heels are touching, knees and thighs are together. Inhale, open up the heart. Nice wide palms, energy, inhale. Exhale, pull it into the heart. Gently lift up, rotate to the other side, elbow across the thigh. Inhale. Exhale, release it. One more time, we're gonna open up. Big starfish hands. And exhale, forward fold. Inhale, lift the arms up toward the sky. And exhale, the hands to the heart. Get nice and warm. Inhale up. Exhale, swan dive forward. Inhale, shift the gaze forward. Exhale, deepen the fold. Inhale, step the feet back into a high plank. Exhale, lower down to a rumble. You can always lower the knees down first if you need to take a modification. And downward facing dog, gently pedal the feet. Relax the ears inside of the biceps. Belly in. Tilt the hips up, press the chest toward the thighs. Five breaths here. Relaxing the child's pose. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Inhale, sweep the right leg toward the sky, three-legged dog. Keep the shoulders square. One more inhale. Exhale, pull the right knee in toward the nose. Inhale, extend it back. Exhale. Inhale, pull the right foot in between the palms. Coming into that crescent lunge, gently square off the hips. Sink a little bit deeper into the lunge and pull that knee up, straightening the back leg. And now we're going to inhale the arms up. Nice open heart. Gently arch the back, shift the gaze up toward the sky. And exhale, fold over, frame the foot. Inhale, lift it up, open up the heart. Celebrate your crescent lunge. Pull the hands to the heart and gently rotate the elbow across the thigh. Pull it in. Inhale, release the twist. Exhale, frame the foot. Step the right foot back to meet the left. You can add a chaturanga in your peak leg, or you can go straight back into your down dog. Gently pedal the feet. Reach the heels back, chest up toward the thighs. Inhale, sweep the left leg toward the sky, gently square off the hips. On
the inhale, bring the knee toward the nose. And exhale, extend it back. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, bring the foot in between the thighs, coming into a crescent lunge on the other side. Gently pull that left hip back, right hip forward, sink down. Lift the knee up on that back leg, straighten out that back leg. Inhale, lift the chest up. Bringing the arms open, open up the heart, gaze up toward the sky. Celebrate the other side, inhale. And exhale, fold over, framing the foot. Inhale, lift it up. Exhale, pull the hands to the heart. Tall spine, and gently rotate that right elbow across the thigh. Pull it back to the center. Nice, gentle twist. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, release. And exhale, frame the foot. Left foot back to meet the right. And we're going to center the right palm and open up into a side plank. You can come to your forearm. You can drop a knee down. I'm going to keep the palm under the shoulder. Stack the feet, or you can stagger them. Whatever works for you. Reach that left arm up toward the sky. Inhale. Exhale. Open up the chest. Inhale. Exhale. One more inhale. Exhale. Bring the left palm down. Bring it back into the high plank. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, center the left palm. We're gonna rotate into side plank on the other side. Reach that nice wide wingspan. Palm to palm, stack the feet, stagger the feet. Whatever works for you, bring the knee down, come down to the forearms. Make it your own, inhale. Exhale. You want a big open heart, wide wingspan, celebrating in side plank. Lots of joy coming in through that top palm. Inhale. Exhale, bring it down. Coming in to your high plank. Lowering the knees down. Press the hips back. Breathe for a few breaths in child's pose. You stay down there in your child's pose. And just relax. Press that chest toward the earth. On your next inhale, tuck the tailbone under and roll up. Lift the head up. You're sitting back on your heels in hero pose. We're going to roll the shoulders back, open the chest up, and bring the hands. You can either recline back, having those fingertips pointing toward the toes, or you can lift the hips up. The main thing is you want to keep your knees right under your hips. You don't want to step them out wide. So if you need to start by putting the backs of the palms here at the hips and shifting the gaze up as you recline back, that's fine. If you can reach back to the heels, you can recline back on the heels. Or again, you can be back here and start with just the palms on the earth and the hips lifted up a few inches. A few different options there. We're going to take about three breaths. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. One more inhale. Exhale, gently release that position. Hips back, palms forward, relax. Counterbalancing that with the child's pose. Inhale, curl the toes under, press the hips back, downward facing dog, gently pedal the feet. Belly in, head relaxed. Inhale, soften the knees, shift the gaze forward. Step the feet to the top of the mat, forward fold. Inhale up. Exhale, hands to heart. Toes and heels together, gently rock from front to back. Inhale, sweep the arms up over the head. Exhale, swan dive forward. Inhale, shift the gaze forward. Exhale, deepen the fold. down, framing the foot. And then inhale, gently rotate right arm up toward the sky. Inhale. Exhale, right palm down to frame the foot. Curl the toe under, lift the knee up. And we're going to step to the top of the mat in a forward fold. And then inhale, step back with the right leg. Crescent lunge on the other side. Left hip back, right hip forward. Inhale. Exhale, lower the right knee down, coming into a low lunge. Inhale, lift the gaze up, lift the heart up. Press the hips forward, reach the arms up over the head, shifting the gaze up, gently arching through the back, open up toward the sky. Inhale. Exhale, bring it down to frame the foot. And then inhale, gently revolve. Lots of opening up today, lots of gentle twists. Heart toward the sky, hands toward the sky. You're going to throw your arms up in celebration. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Bring the left palm down to frame the foot. Curl the toe under, lift the knee up, and step it back into a forward fold. And relax in that forward fold. Let the head hang, kind of shake it out. You can grab opposite elbows and gently sway from side to side. And on the inhale, sweep the arms up over the head and exhale the hands to the heart. Inhale, up, tall, tall spine, gently arch the back this time. And exhale, forward fold. Inhale, shift the gaze forward. Exhale, deeper fold. Inhale, step the feet back into a high plank. In your high plank, you want to keep the chest active and the upper back wide. You've got two options here. We're going to go from right foot forward on the outside of the right hand, and then bring the left foot forward, and then bring the hands up to the heart and grab a squat. And then we're going to bring it back down, left foot, right foot. So this would be option A. We're going to do that on the other side now. Inhale, left foot forward, and then right foot forward. Lift it up. And bring the hands down, step back and back. Here's your other option. I was accidentally getting ahead of myself, although that really wasn't an intentional hop. It's going to be now. You're going to take both feet, hop them forward, and lift up, hands to the heart. So your options are to continue with the step, or we're going to go through 10 nice invigorating transitions, hopping into goddess squat and bringing it back into a high plank. Okay, here we go. Belly and hips down, inhale. Exhale, palms down, hop back. Inhale, hop forward, lift up. Exhale, palms down, hop back. Inhale, hop forward, lift up. Exhale, down and back. Inhale, forward and up. Exhale, palms down, hop back. Inhale, hop forward. Lift up. Exhale. Palms down, not back. Inhale, forward and up. We're halfway. Exhale. Down, back. Inhale, up, forward, lift up. And down and back. Inhale, forward, up. Exhale, down, back. Inhale, forward, up. And down and back. Inhale, forward, up. We got two more. Down and back. Inhale, forward and up. Last one, take it down and back. Inhale, bring it forward and up. Beautiful, beautiful. Bring the palms down. Step or hop it back. Go ahead and take the knees down. Relax back into a child's pose. You stay in your child's pose for about 2 breaths. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. And on the next inhale, curl the toes under, press the hips back, and let's come into a downward facing dog.
On your next inhale, lower the knees down, cross the ankles, and extend the legs out in front of you. We're going to come into a reverse plank. So we'll start in staff pose, tall through the spine. You're going to bring the fingertips behind the hips, look up toward the sky, belly in, roll the shoulders down and back as you puff the chest up. Inhale, exhale, lift the hips up, you can point the toes, and then flex the feet, maybe alternating one at a time. Inhale, exhale, come in and out of this as needed. One more inhale, exhale, lower the hips down, bring the knees into the chest and balance on the tailbone. And we're going to roll back onto the spine, extend the legs up, palms up. You can stay back here with just the chest filled up and that whole middle back on the mat. Or you can lift up, may take two tries, may take three tries, and balance in boat pose. You can keep the knees bent with your boat pose, you do not have to have them straight, up to you. Pull the belly in, shoulders down, palms up toward the sky. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. One more big inhale. And now exhale, roll back, bring the knees into the chest. And we're gonna cross the ankles, tilt the hips up toward the sky, and roll up and through into a table. Let's drop the head down around the back, gently massage the spine, take a cat stretch, inhale it up into cow pose. Bring it back to neutral, curl the toes under, press the hips back, downward facing dog. Inhale, sweep the right leg toward the sky. Exhale, right foot in between the palms, left heel down, and inhale up, warrior one. Shoulder square, belly in, gaze up toward the sky, and exhale, warrior two. Inhale, straighten the front leg, shift the ribcage forward, and we're going to take that right palm to the earth, coming into triangle. If it doesn't reach the earth, that's okay. You can bring it to the shin. You can just have the palm open and allow it to hover. We can take it all the way down. Up to you. Have that back foot kind of at a 90 degree angle, perpendicular to the front. And then gently rotate your gaze up toward the sky. Shoulders low. Try to create a straight line, fingertip to fingertip, or shoulder over shoulder. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale, bring that left palm down. Right palm frames the foot. You can inch the back foot closer if you need to. And we're gonna relax into a forward fold over that front leg. Just appreciate this relaxing stretch right now. On the next inhale, you're gonna revolve your triangle, taking that right arm up toward the sky. We open up the chest, straight line. Shift the weight onto that right leg. Extend the left leg behind you. Open up the hip and gently flex the foot. And then you're going to reach that left arm up. Coming into half moon. You want to stack the shoulder over the shoulder. You can balance. Just bringing those fingertips a few inches off the mat. You can keep them on the mat. If you have a prop like a block, or we use eggs here in the studio, you can put the palm on an egg or a block. Or a rolled up towel, don't need anything fancy. Inhale. Exhale, bring the palm down, gently square off the hips as you soften the knee, and sink down into a crescent lunge. Lower the
spine back, gentle arch through the back. And exhale, fold over the foot. Curl the toe under, lift the knee up. Right foot back to meet the left. You can chaturanga here if you'd like, or go straight back into your down dog. Inhale, sweep the left leg toward the sky. Exhale, left foot in between the palms, right heel down. Inhale up, warrior one. Inhale. Exhale, open, warrior two. Inhale, straighten the front leg, shift the ribcage forward, and bring that left palm down, right arm up. Coming into triangle. Again, you can choose your hand position. You can put the hand on the thigh, on the shin, on the earth. Just lift up. Into the fold. Allow the head to hang. You can just kind of even nod the head or shake it from side to side. On the next inhale, gently revolve your triangle. Again, bringing fingertips up, you can place them on the foot for some height, you can use an egg, take it all the way to the earth. You can even take it one step further by taking that palm to the outside of the front foot. Gentle spinal twist, shoulder swell. Reach the energy through the heel to keep the core engaged. Inhale. Exhale, bring the palm down to frame the foot, square off the hips, and soften back into the lunge. Crescent lunge first, and then we'll go ahead and lower it all the way down into a low lunge. Flatten out the foot. And inhale the arms up, tall through the sky. And gently arch the back and press the hips forward. Inhale. And exhale. Fold over the front foot. Curl the toe under. Lift the knee up. Set the left foot back to meet the right. Chaturanga here if you'd like. Or go straight back into your down dog. Shift the gaze forward and step or hop to the top of the mat, forward fold. Inhale, sweep the arms up and exhale, hands to heart. We're going to go into a single leg balance, kind of like tree pose, well, tree pose, variation on tree pose. And we're going to start with the toes and heels together, the hands at the heart, the belly and the shoulders down low. And now we're going to gently center the left foot, lifting the toes up and planting them into the earth one at a time. Open up the hip and create a little kickstand. You can keep it right here if you need to. If
bring it all the way to the inner thigh, or flex the foot and lift the knee up. If this is where you're at today, this is going to be our invigorating celebration. We're going to have that foot flexed and the knee lifted. You're going to reach the arms up and open. And as you exhale, you'll just reach the arms through to the earth and extend the leg behind you on the exhale. And then on the inhale, we're going to pull back into that celebration. Exhale, bring it down. It's okay for a little wobbly. Just keep that core tight and focused. You're going to bring it back up through. One more time. Take it down. I'm even shaking a little bit here. That's okay. And pull it through. Good control. With practice, it gets easier. Bring it back in and gently pedal the feet. Here it comes on the other side. And again, you can take any variation of tree pose that works for you. You want to start by centering that right foot. Kind of square up the hips. Tuck them in. Everything's tight. Nice control. Toes up and press them into the earth. And then you can leave it in your kickstand if you'd like. You can bring it up to the calf. You can take tree pose with the heel up at the inner thigh. Or if it's in your practice, flex the foot, lift the knee up, and open the arms up. Big inhale. Exhale. Reach it toward the earth. Extend the leg behind you. You know what? If you're really feeling fluid with it, focus on keeping the hips square too. We're going to pull it in. Lift the arms up. Open the chest up. Exhale, take it through to the earth. Inhale, lift it up. You can go at your own pace. You want to do these kind of quick and vigorous, go for it. Slow, controlled, deep breathing, that's fine too. Inhale, lift it up. And take it through. And let's go ahead and bring it up. And bring the hands back to the heart center. Gently pedal the feet. Hands to heart. Inhale, lift up. And exhale, swan dive forward. Relax the head. Inhale, extend the spine, shift the gaze forward. Exhale, deepen the fold. Grab the opposite elbows and gently sway from side to side. Just hanging. You can continue to hang, or you can even take the arms and wrap them around the legs and hug yourself tightly. Feeling that upper back open up. Inhale. Exhale, release. And we'll step the feet back into a high plank. Lower the knees down. Press the hips back. Nice child's pose. Inhale, forward, coming back into a high plank. And take the right foot in between the palms. High crescent lunge, and then sink slowly, lowering it down. Flatten out the foot. Another little invigorating stretch. We're gonna press it back. Rocking the hips back, pointing the toes up. Keep the gaze forward and just fold the belly and the chest over that thigh. On the inhale, come forward. Press the hips forward. Reach the arms up, gentle arching back. Exhale, fold over and press back. Point the toes up. Inhale, press the hips forward, reach the arms up. Exhale, fold over, press it back. Inhale, rock forward, lift the chest up.
Gently pedal the feet. Inhale, soften the knee, shift the gaze forward. Step or hop the feet to the top of the mat, forward fold. Inhale, up. Exhale, hands to heart. Now that you're nice and warm, let's gently rock from front to back, plant some roots in Tadasana, and press the toes into the earth. Bring the palms at the heart and don't quite touch, just hold them together right on either side of the heart. Big inhale. And as you exhale, kind of press that warm energy away from your heart as you extend the arms forward, extend the left leg back, balancing on the right leg, coming into warrior three. Try to square off the hips. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale, pull the hands back into the heart. Bring the knee up, balancing as we did in our tree variation. And bring it back into your mountain pose. Gently pedal the feet. Lift the toes up, plant those roots again, and create that space between the palms of the heart. Inhale. As you exhale, hinge forward, pressing that energy out, reaching through the heel. We're on the other leg now. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. One more inhale. And as you exhale, pull it back in. Lift the knee up. Hands to heart. Inhale. Exhale, bring it to the top of the mat, pedal it out. We're going to reach the arms up, sink the hips down and back, coming into the chair pose. Gently tuck those hips under slightly, pull the ribcage back, and bring the hands to the heart. Inhale. Exhale, gently rotate left elbow across the thigh, feeling that twist, noticing any differences from the beginning of the practice. Inhale, lift it up. And exhale, rotate to the other side. Inhale, bring it back to the center. And forward fold, straighten the legs. On the inhale, you can shift the gaze forward and extend the spine. Exhale, deepen the fold. Inhale, step the feet back into a high plank. Lower the knees down, cross the ankles, extend the legs out in front of you. And we're going to open up into a straddle. You can gently use the palms to kind of help lift yourself forward a little bit. Sit tall through the spine. Don't worry about how much space you have in your straddle, if your legs are closer together or farther apart. Every position is correct. You're going to grow tall through the spine on the inhale. And on the exhale, you'll take that right palm, the back of it, and allow it to kind of brush the earth, pointing up toward the sky, as the left arm reaches over the head, reaching out and over. Don't worry about touching that leg. Just reach it out and over the right side. Nice long stretch through the obliques, through the hips. You can even allow that elbow to kind of rest on the inner thigh. You can take the gaze up toward the inside arm. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale, release that stretch. And we'll take both palms to the top of the knees and shins. Tall spine. Inhale. As you exhale down, you'll take the back of that left hand,
Inhale, release. And now back into that seated position in the middle. You're gonna take those fingertips and bring them in to the inside of that straddle and just start to walk them forward. Keep your gaze forward and hinge from the hip. If you can get the forearms to the earth, then you can rest them there. If not, that's okay. If you can begin to reach the arms out even further, just continue to walk them out as you hinge from the hip, taking it as far as you can. Keep that gaze slightly forward to keep the spine a little bit straighter. And just continue to reach as you feel that stretch through the inner thighs, through the hamstrings. Inhale. You exhale, gently walk the palms back, lift the chest up. You can bring the legs together, gently shaking them out of the middle. It's a deep stretch. You're going to come into a seated position. And now we're going to take that left foot and bring it across the right thigh and just press it into the earth. If you need to keep the ankle lifted, if you don't quite go that way, that's okay. Just keep it up on top of the thigh. And then you're going to press. Got the foot in the earth, you're going to keep the little sits bone pressed on the mat on the left side. Hug the knee in first. Nice big inhale. And as you exhale, you can take that left palm toward the earth and the right elbow across the thigh. Gently press the elbow into the thigh, a gentle twist, and take that gaze over the left shoulder. Next inhale, bring that right palm down, the left elbow across the right thigh. Gentle twist as you take that chin over the right shoulder. Bring those legs around, bring them in front of you, coming into staff pose. Walk the heels away from the hips, sit tall through the spine. Inhale and exhale, hinge forward, reaching toward the toes, past the feet, hands under the calves, wherever you're at, just honor that position. Holding over the legs, feeling that stretch through the low back, through the back of the hips, through the hamstrings. Inhale, exhale, lift up. And scoop out the abs as you lower down. Relax on your back and walk the shoulders away from your ears. You're going to inhale and pull the knees into the chest. Stretching the low back. Point the toes up toward the sky. And reach the arms out to either side into a T. Flex the feet. Pull the belly in so you have that nice flat spine pressed into the earth. Inhale. And as you exhale, you're going to circle them to the left, down, around, and back to the center. Inhale. Exhale, circle them to the right, down, around, and back to the center. And then pull the knees into the chest and wrap the arms around the knees. Inhale. Exhale, extend the arms out over the head. Make the body as long as you can. Complete the inhale. Exhale, pull the knees back into the chest. Wrap the arms around the knees. Inhale.
the arms up over the head. Inhale, flex the feet. Exhale, roll up. Sit tall into your staff pose. Let's do one more forward fold. So loosen up, relax the back hamstrings and glutes and hips. Back into that seated position. And now scoop out the abs again this time. Make sure you have full lungs when you start to scoop out and then completely empty them on the way down. Walk the heels away from the hips. Walk the shoulders away from the ears. Bring the backs of the palms to either side of the hip. Opening up the chest, you can gently pull the shoulder blades together. Lengthen the spine. Close the eyes, and on your inhale, tighten the fists and curl the toes under. Begin to flex the muscles in the calves, the forearms, the biceps, the triceps, the quads, the hamstrings, the glutes, the hips, the belly, the chest, the back. Even tighten the muscles in the face, the neck. As you exhale, nice slow exhalation, completely empty the lungs and release the hands and feet. Relax the forearms, the biceps and triceps. Relax the calves, the quads, the hamstrings. Feel the muscles in the belly, chest, and back melt into the earth. Keeping the eyes and mouth closed, relax the muscles of the face. One more big inhale. And as you exhale, maintain that nasal breath as you feel anything